George Lucas's path to becoming a visionary filmmaker began at USC.
In 1964, George packed up and moved to Los Angeles to attend the University of Southern California School of Cinema. While there, he admits that he found himself. USC provided an opportunity that Modesto just couldn't, a new style of experimental, tactile learning which suited George very well. While at USC, he released a plethora of award-winning films. The avant-garde, futuristic, dystopian story of escape, THX-1138, 4EB. A revolutionary take on focus and editing to music, Herbie.
What can we do for you?
And a fast-paced Look at Life, an animated short that helped pioneer and popularize the rapid photo montage. USC taught George not only filmmaking, but also helped mold him into an insightful film artist. Over the years, he formed a number of critical relationships with like-minded individuals. Close friendships based out of mutual respect and admiration that would last the rest of his life. After graduating USC, George and Francis founded American Zoetrope in 1969. At their location in a loft in San Francisco, George immediately began transforming his award-winning student film THX into his first feature. In 1971, he founded Lucasfilm Limited, the first of many successful Lucasfilm affiliates.
Lucasfilm is considered one of the leading film and entertainment companies in the world.
American Graffiti opened on August 1, 1973. George succeeded in encapsulating his childhood cruising into a film that the entire country and world could enjoy. For his work, he was awarded the key to the city of Modesto.
When he conceived American Graffiti, which, and my small part in influencing George's time around there is I told him, you know, that really the thing was to write and to write about what he knew about. And be a writer. He didn't really think of himself as a writer, really. And then he realized, I think on that production, that he was a writer.
2 years later, Lucas founded ILM, Industrial Light and Magic, a special effects company which created visual effects that had never before been seen. Initially, the ILM crew worked solely on the special effects for Star Wars, but would soon go on to be the industry leader for film, commercial production, and theme park rides. Another 2 years passed, and in 1977, history was made. Star Wars Episode IV, A New Hope, was released across the country. It broke all box office records and was nominated for 10 Academy Awards, winning 6. The first installment of the original Star Wars trilogy would change the way modern movies are made, revolutionizing film visuals and sound. In 1978, George purchased 4,700 acres of property in Marin County, where he began to build Skywalker Ranch, which would become an independent filmmaking center away from Hollywood, a solace from the interfering Los Angeles studios. Skywalker Ranch housed Skywalker Sound, in addition to its function as the corporate Lucasfilm headquarters. Raiders of the Lost Ark, the first of the Indiana Jones franchise, was conceived and produced with best friend, director Steven Spielberg. It opened on June 12, 1981 to rave reviews. This would be another series of films that would eventually lead to George helping to design another spectacular ride for Disneyland. In 1992, Spielberg would go on to present George with the Irving G. Thalberg Award, the Academy of Motion Pictures' highest honor. In 2005, the headquarters of ILM was officially moved to the Letterman Digital Art Center located in San Francisco's historic Presidio. Today, George is considered one of the most successful filmmakers of all time. Director, producer, visual and sound effects pioneer, he is respected as one of the leading visionaries in his industry.
He's fairly quiet. He's opinionated. He's been kind, direct, generous, and some of the other incredible characteristics that seldom accompany someone who is successful and relatively artful.
In recent years, Lucas has taken a leadership role in applying his technical and storytelling expertise in the classroom. He sits on the board of directors for the USC School of Cinematic Arts Advisory Board and is chairman of the board of the George Lucas Educational Foundation. George Lucas's devotion to timeless storytelling has given us some of our most beloved films, all of which celebrate the boundless potential of the individual to overcome any limitations. George has taught us, from his earliest days in Modesto to present day, that with a little imagination, anything is possible. George Lucas is one of the most successful filmmakers of all time. George has been honored with many outstanding awards, an honorary degree Doctor of Fine Arts from the University of Southern California, Lifetime Achievement Award from the Visual Effects Society, the National Medal of Technology, American Film Institute Life Achievement Award, California Hall of Fame Induction, and the NAACP Vanguard Award for increasing understanding and awareness of racial and social issues. In 2007, he presided as the Grand Marshal of the Tournament of Roses Parade. I've known George for so long and we talk all the time, so I've come to understand that his many innovations and endeavors are all born out of a personal sense of what's right and what's wrong, both in the film industry and the world. When people ask me what George Lucas is like, I say he is truly the most honorable person I've ever met. His word is his bond. That's been my experience. Ultimately, George's pioneering spirit comes from a very developed sense of integrity, which also makes him a great friend. The kind of friend everyone hopes for in a lifetime.